So, it finally happened. Nintendo, in their anti-consumerist, greed-hungry rage, has finally taken our beloved games from us. As we speak, Mario is being walked to the podium in Logtown to be executed, where hopefully he'll tell us where he left all his coins he gathered over the years. For some of these games, while it is an unapologetically greedy thing for Nintendo to do, they're not gone forever like we meme about. Super Mario 3D All-Stars and the Mario Game & Watch, while printed in limited runs, are still playable for those who are lucky enough to get them, and you'll still be able to re-download All-Stars if you got it digitally. However, one game in the lineup didn't fare so well in the execution. Super Mario Fortnite got quickscoped by Miyamoto himself. Trust me, I was there. Super Mario 35 was a different beast from pretty much every Mario that came before it. Essentially, it's a byproduct of a night of passion between Tetris 99 and Super Mario Bros. For the NES.
What the hell is this?
Super Mario 35, being an online-only game, is now completely unplayable since Nintendo shut it down. This raises a problem. Today we live in the age of information, where fans are stepping up to preserve games that their creators haven't updated. Normally, like we've shown on the channel with the Pangeasoft videos we did, this isn't a problem, as with a few tweaks, a classic game can run on modern hardware better than it did on its intended platform. Super Mario 35 is a different problem. With it being completely built around online play, it revolves around using Nintendo's online services. This means that even if fans were willing and capable of creating a port, they still would have the task of acquiring and maintenance of an online server just to let people play the game. And this doesn't even take into account the Nintendo ninjas waiting around every corner with swords drawn, waiting for a chance to slice this fan in twain for having the balls to port a dead game. Not to sound pessimistic, but the way I see it, we may never see Mario 35 again. At least without Nintendo giving it back to us directly. And aside from the cost of keeping servers running, I don't see why they shut the game down. We all saw through their schemes with 3D All-Stars and the Fire Emblem remaster, as those were cheap ways of artificially inflating demand. 35 was a free-to-play game, though. The bar of entry was only having an online subscription. The way I see it, they could have benefited more from paying the smaller price of server upkeep and used it as a bonus free game to entice potential customers into buying a subscription to NSO, even if it's dog shit most of the time. On the other hand, they could have other ideas down the pipeline. Get it? Pipeline? God, I'm such a funny and clever individual! You should all subscribe and leave a like and tell me I matter in the world! This year marks the 35th anniversary of The Legend of Zelda, and aside from a few things here and there, and a $60 port of a decade-old game that released for $50, we don't know what Nintendo has in store for it. They could potentially be creating a Zelda 35, retooling old game mechanics and repurposing them for a modern game, similar to how Mario 35 did. But I think this may be more wishful thinking on my end, and this tangent has gone on long enough. So, to me, Mario 35's future looks pretty bleak. With Nintendo pulling it down, not having any statements about its future, the unlikelihood of it ever getting a fan port, and an even unlikelier chance of Nintendo letting fans run it themselves, even if they got it running, I don't see us ever being able to play this game again, unless the Big N lets us of their own volition. So I hope you got your fill of it, because if you didn't, you may have missed your chance.